मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। द इफेक्ट ऑफ करंट ऑन कंपास नीडल वाज फर्स्ट नोटिस्ड बाय द साइंटिस्ट हैंस क्रिश्चियन ओर्स्टेड। ही नोटिस्ड द डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ कंपास नीडल व्हेन करंट पास थ्रू अ वायर। सो व्हेन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट पास थ्रू अ वायर इट बिहेव्स लाइक अ मैग्नेट एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। सो ही जनरली डिस्कवर्ड दिस इफेक्ट। He discovered that the needle of the compass got deflected when electric current passed through a wire placed near the compass. This shows that when electric current passes through any circuit, a magnetic field is generated. That means the wires are behaving like a magnet, and because of this reason only, the needle of the compass kept near by the circuit shows deflection. And it is known as magnetic effect of electric current. What he generally observed is this one. When we are on the circuit, he observed the deflection of the needle of the compass. When circuit is on, we can see the compass needle gets deflected. And when it is off, it again come back to original position. Now, this deflection of the compass needle changes with the direction of flow of electric current. When the electric current flows from south direction to the north direction, the deflection of the compass needle is this way. And when the direction of flow of electric current is reversed by changing the direction of the battery, that means direction of flow of current is from north to south direction, it is just reversed to the previous case. The deflection of the compass needle also changes. It is going to downward direction. Now let's see how the deflection changes with the change reversing the direction of flow of current in the circuit. So here we observe the deflection when the cell is reversed. It is showing the deflection in opposite direction. So first you see the deflection, and when it is reversed, the needle is showing deflection in opposite direction. And when you switch off, the magnetic needle again come back to its original position. Now electromagnet, this magnetic effect of electric current is used to make electromagnet. In order to make the electromagnet, we require iron nail, wires, and a combination of cell, that means battery. So first we need to wind the nail with the wire, make turn and wind the nail with the wire, and connect both hands to this battery. Now this nail will behave like a magnet when electric current pass through this circuit. And as this nail will behave like a magnet when only electric current is passed through the circuit, so it is known as electromagnet. Here, when the circuit is on, the iron nail will attract the pin, and when we off the circuit, it will no longer attract the pin. When on, it is on. This will attract the pin, and when we off the circuit, iron nail will no longer attract the pins. So this shows that when current passes through the circuit, the iron nail behaves like a magnet. So this is an electromagnet. Now few applications of magnetic effect of electric current. First, the electromagnets are used in the cranes, this type of cranes, to separate magnetic materials from the junk. And it is also used to lift heavy objects. Next, this is also used in telecommunication equipments like telephones. The electromagnets are used in the electric appliances like electric bell, electric fan, electric motor. It is also used in the headphone also. Electromagnets are also used in electromagnetic train. These are the electromagnetic train. With the help of the electromagnet, these generally operate, and these are known as maglevs. And it is also used by the doctors, sometimes by accident when magnetic material fall on our eyes. Doctors generally use electromagnets to separate this magnetic material that have fallen in our eyes. Now the electromagnet and permanent magnet are not same. There is a difference. In case of permanent magnet, they maintain their magnetism as for a long period of time. They remain as a magnetic property for a long period of time. But in case of electromagnet, when we on the circuit, only in that condition it will behave like a magnet. When you off the circuit, it will no longer behave like a magnet. It will lose their magnetism. So it behaves like a magnet only when the circuit is closed. Next, advantages of electromagnet over permanent magnet. Some advantages are there. The magnetism of the electromagnet can be switched on or switch off as we require. When we require the electromagnet, we just need to switch on the circuit. And when it is not desired, we need to switch off. But it is not possible in case of permanent magnet. And in case of electromagnet, we can increase the magnetic property of the electromagnet. Just we need to increase the number of turns of the coil over the iron. Or by increasing the amount of current passing through the wire. So this is how we generally make a strong electromagnet. But on the other hand, permanent magnet cannot be made so strong. This facility is not available in case of permanent magnet. Electric bell. This is the electric bell. The electric bell is the inside circuit. It consists of the electromagnet. This is the iron rod, and here the wires are turned. So these two are behaving like a magnet when circuit is on. This is the battery. This is the hammer, and when the hammer hit the gong, we get the sound. And this is generally made up of iron. And this is the spring. When we switch on the circuit is closed. That means it will behave. The current will pass through this iron bar, and this will attract like an electromagnet. And as it will attract like an electromagnet, this electromagnet will attract this soft iron bar. When as long the current flow, it will attract the soft iron bar, and at that condition this hammer will strike the gong and we will get the sound. When this iron, soft iron, is attracted by this two electromagnet, the connection between the spring and the pin get disconnected, and it will behave like an open circuit. And in that case, no current will flow through the circuit. That means the magnetic property of the electromagnet will lose. And in that condition, the iron strip will again come back to its original position. And when it comes back to original position, again the current, it will make a closed circuit. Current will flow. This iron bars will behave like a magnet. And again, it will attract the soft iron piece, and the hammer will strike the gong, and we will get the sound. So this is how the electric bell generally produces the sound. Now let's see how it generally produces the sound. When circuit is on, the current pass through this electromagnet, and as long as it behaves like a magnet, it will attract the iron bar. And when it attracts the iron bar, the connection between this get broke, and it will behave like an open circuit condition. And in the open circuit condition, again the iron strip come back to original position. Again it will behave like a closed circuit. So this is how this part is repeated again and again, and we get the sound as long as this hammer strikes the gong. So this is how the electromagnet is used in the electric bell, and this is how The electric bell generally produces the sound. Thank you.